Here I play against a Shogun on the Alpine Ridge map. So this map favors melee heavy units, melee heavy armies. So this was actually a poor choice on my part, but I just don't have enough vets. Some people, they took advantage of a bug, and so they have more vets than normal, and so they can cheat. Anyway, so AA Shogun I played against him previously in a, you saw the 2v2 battle with Arab Carthage and FP. So I'm gonna quickly move my Wacko Raiders to capture the building. Here his cav does something smart. His cav is able to prevent me from capturing by just moving into a circle. Here, not sure. He might have gotten away with just charging my my Raiders. But he's gonna mobilize really quickly and move up the hill. He needs to because I have the missile advantage. But again, this map heavily favors melee armies because the game moves so fast. And so he's going to surround me, going this way. And here he has an interesting choice. He's going to eventually decide to charge all his units this direction, but what he should have done is that he should, I think, he should have charged this direction to take out these units, because here's why. If he wins this battle, I lose these two units, he probably wouldn't lose anything. He wins this building, and I'm back here and I can't really do anything. So he'll be up two units, up a building, so that was probably what I would do. But I charged my monk units over here to scare these cav units away. But see, as I chase them, this gives them the ability to go this way and kill my heavily unprotected unprotected missile line. This was a huge mistake. Me charging these Wacko Raiders this way opens up. He can go this way. He can go this way and take out these missile units. But see, the thing is that he doesn't charge immediately. You can see on that side, he charges his cav units here, but I get the charge off. And he has three cav units, which are all stronger than mine. But I have spear units, so I'm just gonna come out value-wise on this in this fight. I think he still wins the fight overall, because there is some random element to this. But here, I made a mistake. These guys should have been flanking these guys. But whatever. So he's going to be able to pop into stand and fight right here. And my mistake here is not popping into stand and fight. I do a rally. But the Santa fight actually gives your men fighting bonuses.
Our men are running from the battlefield! Shame for this play!
Yeah, my units are running. So I'm able to chase these cav units away. So it's pretty obvious that this fight is going to be the main melee fight. Here I'm going to take my general, I'm trying to go for a hammer ambush right here, but the units were too sticky, so I decided, you know what, screw it, I'm just going to put these in stand and fight, my general on stand and fight. And his cav were destroying my missile line, but you see, with these two Naginata Vengeance units, he can't really do much, so he's going to run them away. And so this right here becomes a focal point right here. This fight is going to determine who wins. Right here. Yep, this fight. Because I got out of that cav fight really well. So again, as you can see how quickly this turned into a melee blob, that melee heavy armies have the advantage here. And see here, he attacked my monk. I probably would have attacked these missile units because these missile units are doing extraordinarily well for a game that favors melee units. So this is it. right here, he made a mistake. He should have poured everything into here, but this is going to be the end. As you can see, this is it. And I think he's going to concede. And that's it. So, next time you see Alpine Ridge, keep two things in mind. Always bring a melee heavy unit, and keep your infantry line near here. If you notice, he never got his cav around and did some hammer ammo strikes with this thing, this river over here protecting me.